Hello students, in chapter 1 geography part 1 video we have done the meaning of environment, components of environment, biotic and abiotic environment, natural environment and domains or different spheres of environment like lithosphere, hydrosphere, atmosphere and biosphere. Now we will learn about ecosystem, food chain, food web, human environment and man's impact on the environment. So let's start with ecosystem. Ecosystem. An ecosystem includes all of the living things like plants, animals and organisms in a given area interacting with each other and also with their non-living environments like weather, sun, earth, soil, atmosphere, climate, etc. The ecosystem is basically the coexistence of biotic and abiotic components in an area. It can be divided into two types: natural ecosystem and artificial ecosystem. The natural ecosystem is one which occurs naturally. It can be further classified into terrestrial ecosystem, which is on land, and aquatic ecosystem, which is in the water bodies. Artificial ecosystem, it is a man-made ecosystem. The term ecosystem was first coined by Roy Clapham in 1930. Next we will do food chain. Various food chains and food webs are found in an ecosystem. A food chain is the flow of energy from one organism to the next and to the next and so on. They usually start with a producer, which is a plant, and end with a carnivore. In a food chain, an organism gets food from one group of organisms. Example: grass is a producer, which is eaten by a deer, which is a primary consumer. Primary consumer is eaten by a lion, and lion becomes the secondary consumer. In the same way, another food chain, grass is eaten by insect. Insect is eaten by frog, and frog is eaten by a snake, and snake becomes the tertiary consumer. In another food chain, grass is eaten by moth. Moth is eaten by a frog. Frog is eaten by a snake. And snake is eaten by a hawk, which becomes the carnivore consumer. For example, a deer eats plant and a lion eats deer. This is a food chain. The interlinking of food chains are called food web. Food web. Interlinking of food chains are called a food web. Food web is a group of several interconnected food chains. In a food web, an organism gets food from more than one group of organism. It is to be noticed that a deer can also be eaten by a lion and grass can also be consumed by a cow. A deer can be eaten by a lion and grass can also be consumed by cow. Grass is consumed by a deer also, and a cow can be eaten by a tiger also. Deer can also be eaten by a tiger or a lion also. So this is known as food web. Plants consume energy from the sun as they make their own food with the help of photosynthesis, which is passed to the next trophic level when a deer eats grass and further passes to a tiger or a lion when the tiger or lion eats the deer. This way Various food chains connected to form food webs. The biosphere gives us food and fruit and fulfill our energy needs. Next is human environment. Human beings interact with the environment on day-to-day basis and modify it according to their needs. Due to modernization, our needs grew, so we learned new ways to fulfill our needs. We learned to grow crops and create a system wherein transactions take place. For example, barter system, trade and commerce. The discovery of fire, the invention of wheel and the art of growing crops made man live a settled life. Groups of families started living together. This led to the development of communities and villages. The agriculture and industrial revolution led to generation of surplus of food and goods. Every individual is a part of some community and religious groups. Furthermore, we gather things as per demands. Example, to construct a building, we need raw material like bricks, cement, rocks, and wood. For this, we may look to nature. We can get rocks from mountains and wood from cutting down trees. Today's word has been contracted into one unit by the electronic technology, that is by the internet and World Wide Web. Communication has become easier. Technological advancement in transport helped to reach far off places in few hours. Today's man is a part of global village. He lives in computer simulated means artificial, means which is formed by computer, which is not real. Computer simulated means which is formed by computer and not a real. He lives in computer simulated environment, which is known as virtual reality. Virtual reality is a computer simulated environment, means it is not a real environment, it is an environment which is made on computer, where a person can feel his presence in the real as well as in a virtual place. Next is the man's impact on the environment. Man is an important part of the environment. Earlier, he was completely dependent upon the environment, but now he is able to change his environment as per his needs. He played the role of a developer and a polluter, means he develops the things by himself and started polluting the environment also. Man has used resources mercilessly. They use the resources to fulfill their needs as well as their greed. Man used resources mercilessly to fulfill his desire, which led to environmental pollution. The unwanted and harmful agents in the natural environment causes environmental pollution. Threat to environment means anything that can disturb our natural environment. For instance, man-made things such as fumes are polluting the air, land is being consumed to build factories, etc. This led to the problem of pollution. agricultural development introduced artificial chemicals like pesticides and fertilizers to grow crops. This led to the problem of land degradation. Land degradation is the reduction in the quality of the land. Similarly, effluents from the factories, excessive vehicular and industrial emissions, forest fires have led to increase in carbon dioxide and other harmful gases in the atmosphere. This has led to global warming, means the increase in average temperature of the Earth's atmosphere. Glaciers started melting. All these are causing various health problems also. A wise man, Mahatma Gandhi, said that Earth provide enough to satisfy every man's needs, but not every man's greed. Means there is a lot of things which are used to satisfy the human needs, but very less things to satisfy the greed of human beings. So, be a part of the solution, not part of the pollution. Be a part of the solution, not part of the pollution, because nature is a treasure. Help and save it. Because nature is a treasure, help and save it. Thank you and have a nice day.